Well, Knut, the beloved polar bear at the Berlin Zoo, died suddenly in front of hundreds of visitors. But many wonder exactly what caused the four-year-old bear's life to end.
Our next guest spent months studying polar bears for his new documentary, Polar Bears Spy on Ice, premieres next month. Animal expert John Downer is here to help us try to make sense of this strange situation. He joins us from London. Good morning to you. Good afternoon to you, John. Thank you.
Good afternoon, yeah.
Okay, well,
good to speak to you.
So many people have loved this particular polar bear because we saw those adorable pictures when Knut was just a baby and then bigger. You've seen what has happened in the last couple of days. What do you think happened?
Well, it's very difficult to work out. I mean, what seems to be is some sort of seizure as far as I can see, but I'm not a vet, of course. I mean, I spend my time studying wild polar bears rather than bears in captivity. Mm-hmm. But it was a catastrophic event, very distressing to see because, as we know, this bear was a sort of figurehead for environmental concerns around polar bears. And to see it die so publicly and in such a tragic way, I mean, it's heartbreaking. Mm-hmm.
And
but
you
Sorry
to interrupt, John, but you have spent so much time with polar bears. Some have surmised that polar bears don't fare well in captivity and that maybe that's why he had a seizure of some sort.
The polar bears don't do very well in captivity in terms of their mental health. I mean, it's a very difficult environment for a polar bear. If you see them in the wild, I mean, they're traveling 20, 30 miles a day. In the course of a year, they may do 700 miles. And they're continually on the move, and they need a lot of stimulation.
Mm-hmm. And while we look at some of these videos when Knut was just a cub, they're adorable, but you say, having been out in the wild and lived amongst these creatures, they are some of the most intelligent predators on the planet.
I've been in an absolute awe of them. I've studied and filmed many predators in my time, but I was totally blown away when I started to film polar bears. The fact is that they live in this ever-shifting world of floating ice sheets, and they have to catch seals on these ice floes. And to do that, they need incredible intelligence. They need to work out how best to get close to their prey and outwit them, which means they have to kind of hunt in three dimensions. Underwater, they dive down, they even stalk underwater, and they jump from ice floe for ice floe, making the most of any bits of cover. It's an extraordinary world out there, and they are so supremely adapted to live there.
And we're watching your footage right now. It's spectacular, but it sounds like you're making the argument that they should never be in zoos.
I think that's... I mean, personally, I don't like seeing a polar bear in a zoo. But, of course, there's a lot of polar bears now that have been brought up in zoos. And to say you can't release them back into the wild. And they are doing some good because they do galvanize and the interest of lots of visitors. I think the ones which are there, we need to think more about how can we replicate a little bit more of the natural environment, give them more stimulation. They're such curious, intelligent creatures, and they live in an ever-shifting world. When you put them in a pen, that world never changes, and so there is nothing to stimulate them and create an environment which is challenging and in some way represents the way they live in the wild.
Well, you've got some fantastic video pictures, film from the wild. We'll be waiting for the premiere of your movie, Polar Bears Spy on the Ice, comes out on Sunday, April the 17th.
John Downer, thank you.